This summer, Absolute Radio Live will be bigger than ever. Coldplay, Elbow, Kasabian, Blur, Paul Weller, Florence, I Can't Keep Up, No, Stereophonics, The Stone Roses, and lots more. You'll be with them at this year's biggest live music events when you listen to Absolute Radio Live. We'll take you there.
So I'm backstage at the Cornbury Festival here with Nerina Pallot. Hello, Nerina.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. And you?
Very well, thank you. So this is a very family-friendly festival. Did you bring your family?
No, I left them at home.
Oh, cruel mother.
I know, but my son, he's not quite two yet.
Okay.
And if the weather's rubbish, keeping him in a tent would be like an impossibility.
Yes.
He just wants to be out all the time, but we did think about it, and then I quite fancied a holiday. Work for me is a holiday.
Yeah. So. But do you think you're going to be a very cool parent who takes your kids to festivals? Because my parents never did that with me. I never went to a festival with my parents.
I'll probably end up being like a Dina to a Safi, won't I? And my son will be like, Mom, I want to go to a science fair. And I'll be like, no, I'm going to a festival. He's like, I really don't want to do that. I want to go and see how geometry works.
Oh.
So I don't know. No, I don't think you can force it, really.
And did you go to a lot of festivals when you were younger?
None.
Really?
My parents are hideously uncool.
Yeah,
I love them.
Mine certainly never took me. But when you were like sort of an older teenager, late
yeah,
teen.
I did. Well, I think I was about 18 when I went for my first. It was the Phoenix Festival, which no longer exists.
Yes, yep, yeah, yep. Yeah.
And I loved it. And I went to Glastonbury a couple of times. And then I've subsequently played festivals and stuff. Mm. But I do think, I mean, call me an old fart, but I do think you have to be sort of a teenager to really get the full glory of them, especially if it's raining.
I think so, yeah. I saw teenagers yesterday when it was raining, just barefoot.
Yeah.
They thought, I'm just going to take my shoes and socks off. I don't think I could do that.
No, I'm at the age now where, you know, I like to be tucked up in bed with, you know, a nice cup of tea by about midnight.
Yes.
So it's not for me, really.
This is a very posh festival, though. You've played it before, haven't you?
I have, yes. And every time I play it, there's like a really important football cup final while I'm on stage.
Yes, and tonight's one is?
Is Italy versus Spain.
Yes.
Which is possibly one of the greatest cup finals of recent years.
Because you're a football fan, aren't you?
I am, yeah, I'm a gooner.
So what would you have done if England had been playing tonight?
I might have had to put my little radio on stage with me. I think I still will, actually. I think if I've got 3G, I will actually be glancing at the sort of scores.
Really?
I've actually got Sky Go, and I did think about bringing my iPad with Sky Go and having it.
Watch it while you couldn't possibly.
Yeah,
that is incredible.
I could,
multitasking.
I have done similar things in the past.
Really?
Yeah.
And so I'm guessing the audience are not going to be any big football fans there then. It's going to be...
No, I should imagine. But I should imagine at Cornbury they're mostly cricket and rugby fans anyway.
Of course,
so,
yeah, yeah.
I'm just like a lone chav on stage.
And very civilised as well. I saw a man yesterday in one of those canvas chairs but with arms and a drinks holder reading the Times. Just reading the Times on his own in a field. So yes, it is very posh. And of course you missed yesterday the big guests.
I know.
David Cameron, Sam Cam, Rebecca Brookes and Andy Coulson.
That sounds like a foursome you wouldn't really want to spy on, doesn't it?
What if they were all sat in the front row of your sat? They probably would be sitting, wouldn't they? What if they were standing in the front row of your gig? What would you do?
I don't know. I'd have to sit on my hands before I throttled at least one of them.
I think they've gone
I'm
home
not a
now.
Fan, just
no,
in case you were wondering.
No. But I think they have gone. I didn't think they could do
I
two
hope
days.
They've gone. Otherwise, I'll be coming with a big stick.
Also, yesterday, Noel Edmonds was here, and he had his own little VIP area roped off, just him on his own.
Just him and Mr. Blobby.
I suspect to stop people going out to him saying, "Where's Mr. Blobby?"
Yeah.
Or "Can I ring the banker?"
Deal or no deal.
So do you plan tonight to do a lot of your, I like it when you do your talking between the songs, are you going to do a lot of that tonight?
I that's kind of like my shtick, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
We'll see, it depends. It depends how the crowd like it, because sometimes they just think, who is this strange bird on stage, and when will she shut up and actually sing? So we'll gauge it based on the audience. Really.
Have you thought about stopping the music and just doing the talking?
Stand up.
Yeah, have you thought about it?
A few people have said that to me. I am thinking about doing something, maybe to take it to Edinburgh Fringe next year. I've been thinking about a one-woman show.
What show would you do? What kind of thing?
Without giving it away too much, it would be sort of like tales from the sort of... I've had some extremely funny experiences in the music industry and just general stuff on the periphery and met some interesting things and had interesting experiences with very famous people. But because I'm not very famous, I can comment on it with a bit more sort of perspective, and some of the stories are random and I think would make good material.
You should definitely do that. It'd be amazing.
Like my weekend with Kate Hudson, so
on a
boat in Paris.
Really?
Yeah.
Anything you want to share with us now?
No, I'm
saving
it.
You
I'm
should save it. That sounds brilliant. And you're touring with Will Young at the moment.
I am, yeah.
Is he lovely? I think he must be.
He's lovely. And actually, funny enough, Will and I went to the same school, but I was a few years above him at school.
Really?
Yeah. And so it's a bit, that's quite funny. But we've been doing some shows for the Forestry Commission, so we're all outdoors and all in really beautiful spaces across the UK.
So you're like just singing in forests, that's just really lovely, with Will Young.
So hippie, what can I say?
And what's this about this tourism campaign you're doing for Jersey?
Yes, I am the voice of the Jersey advert.
Does this mean that you're the most famous person from Jersey?
Possibly, yes, apart from Bergerac, yeah. It's quite an honour.
And when are these adverts going to be on the telly then?
They've been on the telly for the last year or so.
Oh,
and,
really?
Yeah, and the campaign's been running. And it's actually me and my niece are in the adverts running on the beach. Yeah.
Oh, that's really lovely.
Yeah, it's fun.
And, I mean, the big story at the moment of you, obviously, is the floorboards. How's the floorboard situation?
My life's so glamorous.
Do you want to tell me about that?
Yeah, very quickly, if you ever have a toddler, do not give them your wallet and don't leave them anywhere with floorboards with cracks in them.
Okay.
He took every single card out of my wallet, stuck them under the floorboards. And I'm like a dog with a bone, I can't bear that. If it was one card, I'd have called the bank, but I was just like, oh, it's such a pain to go and get every single card reissued. So I thought, well, I've got a screwdriver and some tweezers. And my husband was out and he came home and I'd sort of ruined the floorboards. But I got my cards.
How many credit cards do you have? I'm slightly worried about your economic situation.
I was more concerned about my Nectar card because I'm very thrifty with my Nectar card. And I realised that if I lost my Nectar card, that was hundreds of pounds worth on my Nectar card. And it's taken me years. And I'm very good about not spending my Nectar points. I'm like a hoarder. So that was my most important.
What about Boots Advantage card? You've got one of those.
Yes, I've got one of those.
Right.
Yeah, there's no card I haven't got.
Okay.
I've even got the Superdrug one with a little mirror on the back of it.
Okay. Really building a picture here. Yeah. Okay. And what about another album? When's that happening?
When I finally write some songs.
Oh, yeah. Of course you have to do that first.
I haven't done that for ages.
So when are you going to do it?
When I write some songs.
But when are you going to write the songs?
One day.
One day. Yeah. And are you writing for anybody else at the moment as well?
I've got a few things in the pipeline, which is one of the reasons I'm useless for writing for myself at the moment. I've been doing some other bits and bobs. But I've just been on the road non-stop. And I had a baby. And I sort of... That I didn't take that much time off thinking about it.
Right.
I think I took about 5 weeks off.
Okay.
So I normally have a backlog of songs, which is why I've been able to keep making records perpetually over a few years. But this is the first time in years where I haven't got a load of songs, which is quite odd for me, but quite exciting as well.
Okay. Well, I'll be patient then.
Yeah, you might have to.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you very much for talking to us today.
You're welcome. It was a pleasure.
This summer, Absolute Radio Live will be bigger than ever. Coldplay, Elba, Kasabian, Blur, Paul Weller, Florence, I Can't Keep Up, No, Stereophonics, The Stone Roses, and lots more. You'll be with them at this year's biggest live music events when you listen to Absolute Radio Live. We'll take you there.